Hi, in this video, I'm going to show how to enable Flask cores for Flask-based API projects. I'm going to show different options available to configure and customize for your project-specific requirements. Let's get started. Here, I have a simple Flask application created with a single root defined, slash root. Which responds hello world. We'll first run this application. The application is started and serving on port 5000. We'll test the single root response for now. I'm going to use the curl command, curl http://localhost. 5000. As you can see, the response printed here. If we wanted to see all the request header and the response header, we need to add dash v option, which is a verbose option, which will print all the headers. As you can see, these are all the request headers and these are all the response headers and the response body. Now I'm going to add cores option for this application. First, we need to install Flask cores, which I have added in the requirements.txt and installed it. Next, we can add the cores option and start configuring. Flask cores support three different options for configuring the APIs. And I'm going to show all those approaches and the way to configure each of them. The first option is the global configuration. Enabling cores for the global application, in the sense like applicable for all routes within that application. We can define it by adding cores and initialize for this application. By adding this single line, you have enabled cores for this application and it will be cores compliant. As there is no specific configurations being done, it will take all the default configuration, which is very open and permissive configuration. So by default, it will allow all origins, it will allow all headers, and it will allow all methods, most of the methods. By adding this cores, I'm going to show the behavior of the API. I'm going to call this API again with a few more options. Browser, whenever making an API call, prior to making an actual API call, it will make a pre-flight request, an options request to see and validate if it is permissive to make this call or not. So I'm explicitly going to make that pre-flight request or options call by setting the options header method here, options method, and I'm going to make this call. And now you can see it has added access control allow origin header to the response and it is set to star while character. It means it will allow all origins. Now we'll start customizing the options for the cores. First, I'm going to make this API to api/version1/hello. And I'm going to create the configuration dictionary here. API version 1 cores config, which is a dictionary. As of now, first we'll control the origins header. To control the origins header, we initialize this origin key with a list of hosts which your application is supposed to allow. As of now, I'm setting it to http://localhost:5000. So here, once I set this configuration, the application will allow or add this access control allow origin header only for this particular request. I have created the dictionary and I'm going to pass this dictionary to the resources parameter. And here for the resource object takes again a dictionary. Here we can define the route which it is applicable for. If you want to configure it for the entire application, you can just make this a slash tar, which will be applicable to all routes. Here I'm going to configure it only for API version 1 APIs, and then pass API version 1 cost configuration. Now we can check this by adding origins header in the request. Header, I'm going to add the origin header. Oh, sorry, we have changed the API version 1 slash hello. Now you can see the access control allow origin response, the actual origin which is sent in the request and matches to the configured origin. Now I'm going to see if we are getting that header again if I change the origin. Say I'm going to pass it as abc.com. As you can see, that access control allow origin header is missing here in this response, and hence the browser will deny to make this request, saying it as a security violations. Now I'm going to make it again here. Now you can see the header present for the localhost. And the next configuration is to configure the allowed methods. Here I can, before making that one, I will make another request by explicitly passing access control request method. Like in the request, I'm going to check whether this method is allowed or not. Say the post method is allowed or not. Oops, sorry, it's not a dash x, it is dash h. Okay, so here, as you can see, like when I explicitly check for the method, the server is responding, the flask calls is adding the access control allow methods header in the response, specifying the default methods which are allowed. Now if we want to further configure this list of headers, we can add another key here, setting methods, and pass the list of methods which we are going to support. Say for now I'm adding options, get, post. Say we support only these methods. Okay, so now I'm going to make this request again with the post. Now as you can see, I'm getting only the configured methods back in this response. And if I make a different request with a different, say I'm going to make it for put, that header is now removed and not available in the response, and hence the browser will deny satisfying this request. Now we will go ahead with the header configuration. Now I will go back to the allowed methods, get, and now I'm going to explicitly check whether the headers, which headers are allowed or not. Say I'm again passing an access control request headers. This is a comma separated header list. Say for now, I'm just going to check authorization. Authorization header. Yes, as now you can see the access control allow header added in the response. And again here, by default, it will allow whatever the requested headers. Here as I'm requesting the authorization header, it will allow that same header again here. Now if we wanted to configure it here, what I can do is, like, I can pass allow headers key, allow headers key with the list of allowed headers options. Say I'm allow authorization, and say for example I'm also, okay, let's see, I will allow only this header. And I'm going to make the same request again. You can see that authorization header present in the allow headers present in the response. Now I'm going to change the authorization, and also maybe I can check for content type. As you can see, it allows only the authorization header and not the content type, because it's not been configured here in this dictionary. So as of now we have seen configuring the origins, methods and allow headers for global application. Now the other option available is to make it specific to an API by using a decorator. Say I'm defining another API, app route API / version 2 / hello def version 2 hello. I'm going to return hello world version 2. Now if we wanted to enable only for this specific resource, we can add a decorator like at cross origin. By adding this decorator, what it does is, like, it's similar to our default course call. Here it allows all the default values. Now if we wanted again to make the configurations specific for this API, for this using this decorator, we can pass same dictionary to the cross origin header. For that, what I will do is, like, I will just duplicate this dictionary as version 2 cross configuration, and I'm going to pass it to the cross origin header. Here in this decorator doesn't take a dictionary, instead it takes a list of options. So I'm going to unpack this dictionary and pass it here to this API. Now if I make this API call again, you can see the same response as version 1 course configuration. I'm going to make a little bit of changes here by adding a new header content type. Now I make this request again. You can see the content type header added in the response. And then the next option to configure the course is by adding multiple keys, route keys in the course. I will comment the decorator here, and I will add the configuration in the resources dictionary itself. r/api /v2/*. and pass API V2 cost configuration. Once I restart the server, you can see the same behavior as earlier. And that's it for now. Hope this video has been useful. Thanks for watching.